So, you can't take off his gloves? Hey, what do you tell Vanes if he's watching?
Let's get the fans a fight. He said he going for the knockout, so what's it, 30? 34 fights, professional.
I don't get paid.
Got over 100 amateur. I've been in there with Vargas, Fernando Vargas, Oscar De La Hoya, Shane Mosley, Pernell Whitaker, Floyd Mayweather, Vernon Forrest. Never hurt, never knocked out. I just seen guys get knocked out in sparring, so he going for the knockout. I like my chances.
Yeah. I like my chances. I'm a betting man. I'm taking the odds.
Uh-oh.
I'm betting on my chin. I'm betting on my chin. Does that mean he gonna fight? I don't think he came to fight when he fought Charlo. He got that headbutt. It's a headbutt, but he just looking. He looking for a way to pussy out the fight. He gave it up. I went into the canine fight with a hurt rib. Everybody knew my rib was hurt. But my whole team, I ain't made no excuses. I ain't talk about it until after the fight. I said, shit, I just won this fight with a bruised rib. That was more emotional than anything, because like 2 weeks before the fight, Floyd was like, if you want to pull out, we can. We'll get it back. And I said, no. I said, these opportunities don't come. I waited 13 years. I said, I ain't pulling out of this shit. I said, make it happen. And the seventh, eighth round, Bob kept, the whole fight, Bob was like, your rib all right? Your rib all right? I was like, it's all right, stop asking me. And then, like, in the eighth round, he called me with a shot. I came back. I said, you motherfucker, now my rib hurt. I said, you been asking me the whole fight, now my shit hurt. And I pulled out of that shit with a hurt rib. He get a little headbutt, and he pussy out the fight. And then he want to make y'all believe that he coming to knock me out on the 12th, and he look for a way out of the fight. So, shit, he coming to knock me out, listen. That means he coming to fight. So shit, 34 fights. You can say what you ever want to say. I got 7 losses. I done lost it to some of the best in boxing, some robberies. One guy that just fought for a title that just, you know, like the fight was going his way till he hurt his ankle. You know, he dropped Danny Jacobs. I fought Danny Jacobs, hurt him as well. That was a close fight. I think it was 96, 94, but I lost some points, so they ended up giving him 97, 94. And I fought Fernando Guerrero at 160, lost that. A lot of people thought I won that fight. You know, I don't cry shit. I just fight, man. 7 losses, but I done lost the best in the game. But he coming to think, man, I'm about to lay down like he laid down the last fight. Shit, he got another thing coming. Ooh. I don't lay down for nobody. If you fighting and shit, you taking fights, and all you looking for is like, shit, I just want to pay. I want to get this fight so I can take care of my kids. Shit, I was going through a divorce. I don't make excuses. I talk about all that shit later, you know? I ain't tell that. I never told that to Fight Hype. Never did an interview. Said, I'm going through a divorce. Just one day, shit. Just go to my Wikipedia page. I'm divorced. And I got joint custody of 3 kids. The one that was on the contender. That shit is hard to deal with, man. And then you got a man fighting and you're taking fights. I fought Joel Julio. Like the same month I signed the divorce papers. So, and custody papers, that shit hard. But I ain't never made excuses, man. I just go in there and fight. No matter what the public think, no matter what anybody think, I just fight. Fuck it. But then ever since I got with Floyd, it's like, fuck it, man. Galena was an awkward guy to fight. I had trained extremely too long. I felt like I had overtrained Eddie. Get to the locker room, Eddie all fucked up. You know, he got IVs all in his arm. He telling me he can't walk up the ring and shit during the fight. He ain't gonna be able to give me instructions. I got, man, that shit fuck with me. But again, I don't make excuses. Just go out there and do what you do. I lost the split decision, but shit, I ain't gonna blame Eddie. I just felt like I didn't have none in that fight. I came back and fought Laura. I'm like, champ, he's like, I'm gonna ride with you to the very end. He's like, just give me 100%, man. I'm like, fuck it, it's gonna be what it's gonna be, whether I win or lose. I fought Laura, I gave him everything I had, man. He was just better. I ain't gonna say he running like everybody else. He was just better at doing what he do, which is the Cuban style. He like, you know, Gamboa don't fight like that. That's why he always either getting quit or he's decided to fight, because he don't fight like that. But with him, he's just very good at boxing. I couldn't catch his ass. He was better at running tonight. The other guy, you know, I came back, fought again. The champs like how I fought Laura. y'all gotta realize, Laura is one of the best in the division, hands down. Take away Floyd, take away Canelo, take away Cotto. I know that he's saying he wants 60, but you take them three away out of junior middleweight, Floyd is the best, but you can mix them three up any way you can. Laura, Cotto, and Canelo. And I fought him the best that night, and I gave him the best I had. I fought him better. A lot of y'all probably said he gonna knock me out. I fought him better than anybody. Came back, won a tough fight against a guy that was 20-1. Bookies made that shit real close. I know everybody in the gym made some money on that fight. Then I go watch Vanez fight, and everybody like, shit, he barely lost. Well, what did he do that fight? Like I said, he looked for a way out. So I'm not gonna make predictions to say nothing like that. I'm just gonna go out there and give it 110%, like I've been doing since law, since I won the title. A lot of y'all probably pick K9. Too strong, gonna knock him out. Went to Detroit. Champ said, you know what's in Detroit? I said, I don't give a fuck about that. I said, I got a good promoter. Y'all gonna make sure the judges are fair. I said, I was going to people's backyards as the B side. I feel like I'm the A side. I went to Detroit, took his title in his hometown. Told him at the press conference, I said, y'all booing me now, but after the fight, y'all gonna be cheering me. What happened? Took your shit. Now he a champ again. So shit, man, I'm fighting the best of the division. Vonnet had never been champ. Y'all pick him, that's fine. Like I said, he pussy for his last fight. He looked for a way out. I don't make excuses. I don't blame the judges. He said he gonna knock me out, then y'all should be in for a very entertaining fight. Like I said, 34 fights, I ain't never been hurt, never been stopped, been at some of the hardest punchers, Randall Bailey, Joel Julio, went up to 160, fought Daniel Jacobs. I done fought a lot of motherfuckers, man. I ain't never been hurt. I'm betting on my chin. I'm taking them goddamn odds. Taking them odds.
There you have it. EK Smith. Thank you.
EK Smith.com, back recording.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secback, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.